Sports. It's in the game.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give a shit about what they say.
Let's go ahead and create your avatar. So we've set you up with a home and away starter uniform just to get you geared up. And here's how. Super Bowl 56, there's a look at SoFi Stadium just south of downtown Los Angeles. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Dallas Cowboys and the Los Angeles Chargers.
Time long, set to kick off.
The ball on the tee, we're set for football. And we are underway in Southern California. This will make it into the end zone. And they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25. Now we'll see what the right arm of Dak Prescott has in store as the Dallas Cowboys offense sets up shop.
One thing he does very well, he takes care of the football. Had 176 pass attempts to start his career without an interception. That's the most in NFL history. And finishes rookie year, 23 touchdown passes and only 4 interceptions.
Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses. A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Looking to throw, Prescott. And there is Amari Cooper, his first catch. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
Prescott's throw going to be caught by Gallup, and he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers' 38-yard line. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
Well, that certainly has to feel good, and it's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
It's Elliott. The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a second and long. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved. Just as you said, they want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
That pass play wound up for negative yardage, so here's second and 11. Prescott yet again. That is incomplete.
Prescott's pass incomplete on the throwaway. It's third down.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. To the air again, Prescott. Looking middle, and that's complete. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down. And he's had great protection back there to throw, really been able to survey from the pocket.
That means the jersey stays clean, so the dry cleaning bill, that's reduced. It also means the trainer doesn't have to deal with him because he's not getting hit. Also means that he's able to find targets downfield at his leisure. That allows him to be really accurate.
Set to take over again on offense. That opening drive looked good for a moment there, but they'll wind up being turned away thanks to the missed field goal.
And those especially hurt when you come into a game on the road. You're trying to get things to go your way early, and now you suffer a setback right out of the gate.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. From the shotgun, here's Herbert. The 20, got a man over the middle, it's Williams. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially.
That was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Herbert operating from the red zone. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, LA. From 13 yards out, as his guys are first on the scoreboard here this afternoon. Walking into the stadium, we saw a ton of people donning the jerseys of this rookie quarterback, so you know they love that opening drive, and he throws a touchdown pass.
You get a little bit of confirmation about what they had hoped, right? Because they thought they had a quarterback. They're thinking they have a quarterback. You do this, they believe they've got a quarterback. Look how they're elbowing each other up in the stands. That's our guy.
Time for one play on offense. 7 seconds to go in the half as the kick is away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. A but we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. Here's a second and two now from the 33. Final play of the half, Prescott. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. So we've reached halftime with just the lone touchdown here. 7-0 is our score. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome everyone to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. We saw a strong first half from our quarterback. His guys have the lead, as we'll hand it back over to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. So the Chargers will start the second half with the lead and the football as we're underway in the third quarter. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
At their own 17-yard line.
Out comes the Chargers as they'll go on offense now to start this third quarter. And certainly they'll be hoping to hit pay dirt like they did on the last drive. Got the football back, so a chance to go up two scores.
And they haven't been tentative at all in this ball game, because sometimes you start a game with your script to try and get information out of the opposing defense. How will they play you in certain situations? Sometimes you script to attack, and that's what I'm seeing so far. Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
It doesn't look like this defense found the magic elixir at halftime. This offense was rolling in the first half, and that's continued here in the third quarter. Another big play right there.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Back to throw here, Herbert. He'll find Williams on the slant. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the...
He's got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Chargers. Virgil Green there to make the grab. And the Chargers are going to add on to their lead. There was a lot of zip on that pass, and baseball might have called that a frozen rope.
I like it when you bring the diamond into the game. I'm going back to the gridiron. Had some heat on that bad boy. Sometimes you throw a touchdown pass, and sometimes...
You throw, what, a touchdown strike?
There you go. That's my man, in concert.
And it's good to make it 14-0. And they won't be able to run another play. Time has expired on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Time on, set to kick off.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. Pollard elects to keep it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line.
Yes,
So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. From the gun, he'll set up to throw. Got his man there, complete to Gallup. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks. He's going to find Gallup here complete. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Give him back-to-back catches now. That one for 16. And another first down. Casey Hayward, the Pro Bowler, there to knock it away.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
A second down throw for Prescott. It'll hit the slant route. That's caught by Cooper. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers' 27-yard line. Give him 15 there, and the Cowboys have a first. Throw right side, taken in by Gallup. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Now throw again, Prescott.
Nice game there, partner, but you and I both know that won't do anything for the final score. They're not going to win this one. Right now they're playing for pride and fantasy points.
And just to erase that goose egg, nobody wants to be shut out.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
And this is caught. It's Cooper. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. Again, it's Prescott. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
What a job by this defense all game long. They've come together and really said, no one's crossing our goal line, and they're definitely not going to start right now.
You can just see the dejection. Feel like nothing is working off. And it's caught. He's got it for a late touchdown, but probably a little too late. It would take a miracle of epic proportions if they're going to pull this one off.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed, but if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right, and if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like,
yeah,
you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
And a pause in the action because the booth, they see something that they want to take another peek at to find out if this was a touchdown or not.
Zerline lining up for the point after.
It took them an extra look, but they found out it is a touchdown indeed. The official says this one counts. And it's up and good. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it culminates in a Dallas touchdown. So 15 ticks remaining as they line up for the onside kick. And this is going to be taken in by the Chargers, and it appears they're going to win this football game. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in the football game.
Well, they certainly didn't appear to be fired up about their options throwing the football. So, to me, this seems like a case of just kind of taking their medicine there, run the ball, see if they can pick up something. Instead, they were throwing for a loss.
So this one's over. It's in the win column for the LA Chargers. And you look back over the score sheet, interesting. A very clean game, no turnovers by either side.
An absolute rarity when we watch games now because defenses have put such an emphasis on taking the ball away. But what we saw here was offenses spending their time saying, look, you know they're coming for it. Ball security is paramount. So they worked on that, not just the week of practice, but I'm sure all during training camp. Make sure when you have it, tuck it away because danger lurks everywhere you turn.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. So long, everybody.
Searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.